boys, hey girls, happy Father's Day. Or it may be after Father's Day. By the time you see this, it's before right now. And anyway, go make a French dip. Which is just basically a chuck roast cooked down in a nice gravy, a thin gravy, for French dip. And it's salt and pepper, onions, garlic. And you don't really want to use, you don't have to use like French onion soup in it, or consomme or beef broth or any of that. Because you're going to make your own beef broth from scratch by browning the meat down first with salt and pepper on it. And then you could finish it in a crock pot from there. But we're going to do it stovetop, Cajun style. And got a little problem. My garbage disposal started leaking water through the motor housing. It's cool. I opened the bottom of the sink to get a cleaner out, and I saw water down there. I had a little catch thing, a little plastic thing down there. Luckily it was there. It was about half full of water. I said, uh-oh. So I got a new one coming to get it put in, pain in the butt. But that's okay. It's on the, I got a ground fault on it. It's a Cajun kind of ground fault. It if it's running and it shocks you, it's your own fault. Nah, that's how that works. You just know not to do it again. Yeah. So let's get started, boy. So the first thing we're going to do is rinse the meat in the zinc. Give them a little bath. Go over that bath in the zinc. Dripping dry. Wring it dry. Yeah, there you go. I got that pan in the middle to remind me not to run no water in there. Or really, Miss JV, not to run no water in there. She kind of forgetful. Let's pat him dry. Other side too. Now let's salt and pepper it. Heavily salted, heavily.
Happy 16th anniversary to Bob and Kim LeBeau on June the 23rd.
Well, you're gonna make the gravy have some salt in it. Both sides. Let's go brown it off. Okay, into our pot. In go. We're going to give it a good brown on both sides. Well, cutting no fat off, because that's going to make the gravy nice and rich. And these are splatter shields that we just, Miss JV just cleaned the stove. And if they catch a fire, the sink is right there. We're going to throw them in the sink and run some water on the splatter shields. And then chunk them in the waste bin. Okay? Now you could do this in cast iron, but it don't heat any more evenly. And I done showed y'all that in another video. What the cast iron does do is hold that heat for longer. So if you need to raise or lower the heat, it's going to take it longer to change temperatures than this Revereware will. Same way with those pots with them thicker bottoms, make them hold heat for a little longer. So changing temperatures takes a little longer. Whereas this one is almost instant. now, once we get a nice brown color, we're gonna flip it. Ain't that pretty? Brown the other side. If your pot starts popping, the fire's too hot, boy, cut it back some. Okay. Whoa. Easy, boy. Both sides are beautifully brown. We've got a nice brown flan down in our pan. We're gonna put our chopped onion in there and chase all them grimies out of the bottom of that pan down there. So that's where the flavor's at. And that's how the stock gets made. Real stock. Not the stuff in the cardboard box or the can. It's the real McCoy. Who watched that old show, The Real McCoys? Anybody remember that? It's in black and white. The TV, black and white TV. That's what we had when we went to, when I was growing up. Two channels, three channels, all black and white, and a TV station signed off at night. What was it, about 9, 10 o'clock? And on Saturday, if they had the late show, they would stay on, stay running till the show was over, the late movie. See how nice that looks down in there? Them onions gonna deglaze that pan simply by the water coming out of them. I think they need a little bit of help though. I said come out of there. Not help, flavor. A little bit of red vino. That was Cabernet Sauvignon. But don't let that wine boil. It'll get bitter. It'll simmer it, but that's it. Go ahead and put our meat back in. And we're gonna put some garlic in there. And see this loveliness right here? All of that gotta go back in there. Every last drop. It come out of that meat. Let's cover it with dyed water. And at this point, you could put it in the crock pot. That was 4 cups.
Just rough chop some garlic and put it in there. It's gonna cook to pieces. Mostly like the onions are too. You can add whatever kind of mirepoix you would like. I like oregano and thyme. Just don't put too much thyme, just a little sprinkling. Because it's strong stuff. But you could put bay leaf too if you wanted to. And you're going to have to check the water now while this is cooking.
We've been cooking now for about 2.5-3 hours. And let's check it for salt. Oh, it's got a delicious flavor. It needs some salt. So we're gonna do that. And I know the meat, I can already tell, look, it's just falling apart. See right there? See how that's doing? So this is ready. I'm gonna salt it and put it in the oven on warm, because we don't want to boil it to death. You don't want to keep boiling. It's going to be a thin gravy. Like I told you, you want to thicken it up, then put some starch in it. It don't matter what kind, you can use instant potato flakes or cornstarch or flour. You got, don't just pour it straight in that hot pot. I just pull it off the fire and it stopped burling. So you got to mix cornstarch or flour with water and then put it in here, bring it back to a boil. But we're done with boiling this. I don't want to boil it anymore. Got plenty of gravy for plenty of sandwiches, and we can keep whatever's left over. Beef stock. Oh, hell yeah. Excellent beef stock. It's low sodium right now, but you know we're going to fix that. So go ahead and set your salt was added. And I checked it. It's perfect. Set your oven for about 300. And no, it ain't going to burl at 300. It's like shake and bake, okay? It's going to lightly simmer. And you can check you after a while. Dinner's ready. Okay, we're all ready here. The meat's just pulling apart. So you just take you some. Smash it up, put it on your sandwich. Miss JB put some provolone, mayonnaise, and pickles on hers, because that's how she likes it. She's gonna put it in the sandwich press and get everything nice and hot. We'll serve it with some dip, French dip on the side.
You really want to use smoked provolone cheese on this because it just makes a difference. And then you can either press it in a cast iron pan if you'd like, or if you got a penne press or a smooth top like this one, it doesn't matter. Like I already mentioned, you can do this in a crock pot totally, just using like beef consomme or French onion soup mix out of the can, but this way is totally from scratch, and you don't really need that if you brown in that meat first, because that's what really gives it its own unique flavor without all the garbage in it, with all the stuff in it that's in those canned soups and stocks. And we'll go over that at the end of the video, talk a little bit more about canned stocks and those cardboard tube stocks or whatever. But and you can just put the meat in the crock pot and let it go. And even if you brown it in the oven, say on broil, it's still not going to give you that flavor that about browning it in a pot does. As those little grimies of the brown on the bottom of that pot is a special flavor that can't be duplicated any other way. It and by doing the onions in there afterwards, man, it gives them such a wonderful flavor, and it just can't be duplicated in the oven. And you get a little bit of au jus off the meat in the oven, you know, some of the drippings off the pan, but it's not gonna be the same, trust me. Do it in a pot. Use smoked provolone, put you some mayonnaise. I like my bread buttered, which I did, and I put it on a sandwich press to just kind of melt the butter a little bit, and then put the cheese on it, and yum. You see me catch that one that dropped on the stove, that little piece of meat. Get your dip, lean over something, or it's going to drip all over you. I guess this is similar to a sandwich. Yeah, it's similar to a Italian beef sandwich, except it doesn't have bell peppers in it. Yeah, so get you some pig skins or pork skins or your favorite chip, dip them too. Yum. And I ate two of these. About that same size, too. Yum. Oh, my. If you really want to take a shortcut, you just don't have time. You can get some of this Johnny's au jus French dip mix at the store and get some sliced roast, thin sliced roast beef at the deli and build your own with a hoagie bun or whatever. But boy, it sure is good homemade like this with your favorite chips and just a yum. Here's my second. So here's that section on the store-bought stock.
Let me mention, too, like the store-bought beef broth that they sell, ain't really got no beef in it. It got beef flavoring. What is that? Now, chicken broth actually does have some kind of chicken dehydrated something or another in it. It actually tastes better than beef broth. But this is a beef dish, so we ain't gonna put chicken broth in there with it. Save that for the chicken dishes, like chicken stew or something with chicken in it. Chicken and dumplings, for instance, as you a good example for chicken broth. Now you make it get the all natural beef broth that's gonna cost twice as much, but like I said, we're gonna make our own. Don't need it.
Chiquita is so happy to be home, she's taking a little nap. Good dog. A boy, a girl, a bye.